Welcome everyone to our course today, where we will go through the foundations of LLM agents and how to unlock the potential of enterprise H2OGPTe and its agents. In today's course, we'll go through concepts that you may have heard, such as LLM chains, agents, function calling, routing. We will also introduce a popular benchmark for AI assistant called Gaia. Finally, we'll see how to use H2OGPTe agents for your use case. Let's get started. So what are LLM chains? LLM chains can be seen as pipelines or sequence of actions, which can link LLMs with tools, functions, and even other specialized LLMs or external services. In an LLM chain, the execution can be linear and has a predefined logic focusing on executing a sequence of tasks to achieve a specific outcome. In a chain, actions are predetermined and fixed in the code. But why LLM chains? By integrating large language models with other applications, tools, and services, it helps leveraging the strengths of other tools and services on top of those LLMs to create a more powerful and versatile AI system. It can, for example, overcome LLM-own limitations, for example, mitigating hallucination using tools such as retrieval-augmented generation, or RAG, or simply formatting the input of an LLM or its output, for example, to be integrated into applications such as personal assistant or chatbots. This way, it provides accurate and useful outputs to a various range of inputs. Now, if we go a step further, agents are systems that use LLMs as reasoning and planning engines this time. It really uses the natural language understanding and generation capabilities to build on top of it. The agents evaluate the user's input or query and decide which tool or function to execute, for example. Where LLM chains are particularly useful for applications which requires a series of steps to generate a response or perform an action, agents are more versatile and can be used in applications that require an unknown chain that depends really on the user's input. Now, agents can also be generalist or task-oriented. Maybe they can be good at a various range of tasks, or they can be exceptionally good at a very specific task. We will see an example later. Now, we've seen LLM agents, LLM chains, and we talked about tools that could be used. For example, retrieval augmented generation. Now, how is the LLM agents or even the LLM aware of that? First, let's define what tools are. Tools are really atomic functions that can be used by the agent. When an agent is initialized, the function attributes or parameters are used along with the tool description and baked into the agent's or LLM system prompt. For example, on the right-hand side, we see the tool called Get Country Information. We have a description for it, and we know which parameters are accepted as input. In our case, country and field to extract are two attributes which are required for this tool to properly work. This is really helping to get information about a country. For example, here we see that the field that can be extracted are one of capital, currency, population, or a map of the country, for example. Now, obviously, those tools can be very different. They can be news API, for example, web search tool. They could be an endpoint to a machine learning model, or they can be even like launching an AutoML tool to be able to build a ML pipeline. They could be using an existing audio transcription service or even like be using a code interpreter. The idea is that this description, by being baked into the agent system prompt, it lets the agent know which tools can be used for what purpose and what attributes they require. So how is this fitting all of this together? Routing is really the core of it, where agents decide what actions or chains to take next based on an original user query, maybe even intermediary information it has collected in its memory, and its current state and the tools it knows it has available. The agents decide which actions to take. As I said, the agent can be a generalist or task-oriented. For example, we could imagine that an agent would be a routing agent. Its goal is to determine which agent or which steps to take based on a task that it's intended to do. Let's take the example on the right-hand side for a user interested to know what should be an appropriate outfit for a walk in Central Park today. This user query is passed on to the LLM agent, which analyzes the query and plan a message. This message would be, for example, if we break down this user query, we know what information we would need: a knowledge of the weather today, where Central Park is, and what appropriate clothes would be required. Although Central Park and maybe clothing associated with certain weather can be retrieved from the internal LLM knowledge, the weather can only be known if a tool such as a weather API is available. Here at the bottom, we know that the LLM agents has access to three tools for that very simple example: the weather API, a news API, and a stock API. Obviously, here, two of them are not relevant. However, weather API seems like a good tool to understand what the weather is today in Central Park, New York. So what comes next is that the LLM agent, after analyzing and planning what's to go next, return a message and a state, that is, where whether it's done or it needs to continue, to the routing system. Again, as I said, the routing system here could be as simple as if statements. It looks at the LLM agent state, whether it should continue or whether it's done and finished. But it could be also an LLM agent router. So a specialized agent, which task is to understand what goes next, whether this goes to on another LLM agent or whether this is an answer that can be returned by the user to the user directly. Here, the routing system choose to create next, to use next the get weather API and use as attributes the city, New York City, and in the New York state. The tools being executed returns the temperature, whether it's sunny or raining, and then the wind speed as well. With that information that the LLM agent has now, it can decide what's next, whether it has sufficient information to be able to create an answer and then return it to the user. Here, maybe if it's in a finished state statement, the routing system can choose to return the answer to the user query. For example, some information about the temperature and then the subsequent appropriate outfit suggested by the LLM agent. Now, how do we benchmark or how do we measure how good AI assistant may be or even an LLM agent may be in executing those steps in an efficient manner? A benchmark for general AI assistant, Gaia, has been introduced in November 2023. And this benchmark contains 466 human design questions, which are able to demonstrate the core ability around reasoning, multimodal capability, or tool use. The idea is also to look at how many steps AI assistant may be taking to be able to achieve and address a specific outcome. Where maybe typical metrics are less human-friendly, the set of questions that are designed within this benchmark are simple for human and are easily verifiable for us. They do require multiple steps, planning and reasoning. And more importantly, they do not rely on internal knowledge, for example, of the LLM, as the answers of those questions are not retrievable from the training data because they require steps. Therefore, it helps really assessing the reasoning and planning capabilities of AI assistant, such as agents. Now let's have a look how Enterprise H2oGPTe can help you with your use case. Enterprise H2oGPTe provides its own LLM agents and toolkit that the user can choose to switch on or switch off. In addition, Enterprise H2oGPTe is integrated with H2O Eval Studio, which among metrics to measure LLM, retrieval augmented generation performance, also has Gaia integrated. Let's have a look at it. Let's now get started with Enterprise H2oGPTe agents. First, I have started a new chat and I'm going to customize the chat. I've clicked here. The settings I can see straight away are LLM. I can choose which LLM I'd like to use, Enterprise H2oGPTe being LLM agnostic. And I'm going to select use agent. Here I have a few settings available to me. First, I can specify the accuracy for the agent response. I can get a quick and fast answer, but maybe less verification will be done and it will be a less accurate answer potentially. Or I can have this to the maximum level, leading to higher accuracy but higher running time. Let's leave it as is. Next, I can specify the maximum number of internal agent interaction turns. That is how many tools and interaction the agent is going to have, which could take and lead to a long time. This is particularly useful when you have convoluted and really complicated questions, which will lead to, you know, that you need multiple tools to be able to answer the questions. Then next is the max agent turn time. That is specifying the maximum number of seconds each turn by the agent can take in seconds. So again, if you have steps that will take a long time to run, maybe some tools that will lead to long running time, then you may want to increase that value. In terms of the tools available to the agent that they are aware of and can use, here is a list of the tools that you can switch on and switch off based on your requirements. Here, we have a list of multiple tools, including H2O Driverless AI Data Science Tool, which is the H2O AutoML tool, which means that you can create machine learning pipeline using enterprise H2O GPTe agents. But you also have some news API or image generation tools, as well as audio transcription and so on. Let's take the example from earlier about an appropriate outfit for a walk in Central Park today. Here, I can show the thoughts of the agent so I can see the steps and reasoning process the agent is taking to get to the answer. Fantastic. So I have a few indications about what I should wear today, knowing that there's potentially some rain coming up and it's only 70 degrees Celsius. So perhaps, you know, having a light jacket or windbreaker would be a good idea. Great. Next, let's talk about the Gaia paper from the Gaia benchmark we were talking about earlier. Let's say that we'd like to retrieve the paper and then maybe share some examples of the questions that are asked as part of this benchmark. I'm also going to ask as well to generate or give me a picture of the fifth author of that paper. Let's also retrieve this as a PDF. I may maybe increase slightly the number of turns here. Oops. Requires by the agents to be able to get a response. I'm asking a couple of things, so maybe it will take a bit more interactions to get to the answer. And let's run this. Awesome. So now the agent has finished. I can see that I have an example of one of the questions from the Gaia benchmark. I can see the authors as well of the paper. It's not exactly what I've asked, but I can see that Yann Lequin is the fifth author. And I have finally a picture of Yann Lequin as well available. If I click on downloadable files, I can retrieve Yann Lequin pictures. And I can also see a PDF of the Gaia original paper released in November 2023. I'm going to close this now. Maybe I'll also close that. Next. Let's stay into the subject of AI and let's generate a detailed report as a PDF as well this time on the Hugging Face library TRL. But let's ask H2GPTe to generate a report for a non-technical audience. Let's also ask it to create clickable web citations for every single fact so then the user can actually click on them. All right. I'm going to show the thoughts as well. Awesome. So now I have a final answer here. I know that the PDF has been now created and I have a summary as well of what has been, what is the content of that report. Let's have a look at the downloadable files. Oh, this one. Fantastic. And I do also have access to the link of the TRL library. Brilliant. Next, let's move on and let's talk about stocks. I'm going to ask H2OGPTe now to create a Python code to plot both Tesla and Meta stock price gains year to date versus time per week based upon today's date. So it has to figure out as well like what time, what date it is. Finally, I'm going to save the plot to a file name called stockgains.png. And I'm going to ask it as well to execute that code that I've asked him to create. Awesome. So now I do have a Python script available to me that allows me to be able to execute that Python code. Obviously, you know, I will have to check the code is actually accurate. And I also have a plot that has been created where I can both see Tesla and Meta stock price gains over the last year. Now in the downloadable files as well, I'm able to see the actual plot. Now, let's use Driverless AI and let's ask Enterprise H2oGPTe to build a model, namely to predict churn using the data available here, where churn is available as a target column. And let's prompt Enterprise H2oGPTe to use H2O Driverless AI. We're also going to ask to provide an AUC-ROC curve, as well as F1 score, F1 score, and any related insights. Driverless AI has now completed the experiment, and Enterprise H2oGPTe is displaying the result. We can see the model performance in terms of the F1 score and the AUC-ROC curve that is displayed here. In addition, Enterprise H2oGPTe did put the precision and recall AUC, which is looking good and quite similar in the test set as well. So we could assume that there is little to no overfitting here. We can see the feature importance as well, and some additional insights as well. We can see the lift chart, as well as the precision recall curve, the ROC curve, cumulative gains charts, and so on. In addition to this, it's also displaying some recommendations in terms of how to use that potential churn model.